Just as convertible securities can be found in the equities market, they can also be found in fixed income investing. Convertible bonds are corporate bonds that investors are able to convert to a set number of shares of the issuer's common stock. As a result of this potential for growth, the coupon may be relatively lower than that offered for a similar non-convertible bond. The stock price at which a convertible bond can be exchanged for shares of common stock is called the conversion price. The conversion ratio, an expression of the number of shares of common stock for which a convertible bond may be exchanged, can be found by dividing the par value of the bond, typically $1,000, by the conversion price. For example, if a convertible bond has a conversion price of $25, the conversion ratio is 40 to 1. This means that the bond could be converted to common stock once the underlying stock price reaches $25. In this case, the convertible bondholder will receive 40 shares of the issuer's common stock. Corporations may enjoy some advantages by issuing convertible bonds. As mentioned before, these bonds typically have lower interest rates, reducing the amount issuers must pay out to investors. Also, when bonds are converted to common stock, the issuer no longer has to make fixed interest payments, which ultimately reduces its debt. Another advantage to issuing convertible bonds as opposed to common stock is that doing so does not instantly increase the issuer's number of outstanding shares, which would otherwise reduce earnings per share. Of course, this initial benefit can later become a disadvantage if bondholders convert their bonds to common stock. Corporations also run the risk that a sizable number of simultaneous conversions could have a significant impact not only in terms of earnings per share, but also in terms of voting rights that come with common stock ownership, which could effectively alter company control. Sharing qualities of both fixed income and equity securities, convertible bonds offer investors some additional unique benefits. For instance, bondholders that have not initiated a conversion maintain their precedence over common stockholders in terms of liquidation. Also, if the security is not converted, a convertible bond continues to pay a fixed rate of interest and the par value is returned at maturity, except in cases of default. Typically, these interest payments have a higher priority of payment than the dividend payments to which holders of common stock may be entitled. Keep in mind that a convertible bond is not entirely immune to volatility that may be experienced in the market in general or by its underlying stock, and rather may be more susceptible to this market risk than comparable non-convertible bonds. Should the investor decide to exchange convertible bonds for common stock, he or she can do so with no additional tax obligation, as such a conversion from bonds to stock is not deemed to be buying and selling from a taxation perspective. To continue building your investment knowledge, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.